person, Sue Palmer. Welcome, Sue.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Sue Palmer, and I'm pleased to be a candidate for City Council. I'm the Vice President for Finance and Administration at the College of St. Benedict. It seemed like a tricky mic. Where I oversee all the financial aspects for the college, I manage a budget of about $50 million at the college. I have a bachelor's degree in accounting and MBA from St. Cloud State, and I currently serve on the Planning Commission for Rockville. I got involved in that about a few months ago and decided the next step was to look at running for City Council. I'm interested in a position on the City Council because I would like to help the citizens have a voice in the future growth and development of our community. I've read the comprehensive plan carefully, and I think it has many exciting components that we need to ensure are done in a way that preserves and enhances the unique aspects of our community. We are the fourth or fifth largest city in the state, not quite sure which, by land mass. The natural and physical features of our city are both a great resource and a factor in development. According to the comprehensive plan for the city, to the extent possible, should promote, protect, enhance, and preserve natural and physical features while managing requests for development and redevelopment. My priorities are derived from the city's comprehensive plan. When the two cities were combined, one of the goals was to provide services that were cost-effective. We need to ensure that there's adequate fiscal oversight and reasonable budget increases. We must have a viable approach to the provision of city services. The comprehensive plan states, in administering the construction of these increasingly costly systems, the city must constantly anticipate, if not control, the amount and location of demand. Failure to maintain a managed approach would be fiscally irresponsible and could put the city in jeopardy of engaging in a trade-off between environmental quality and financial solvency. My second priority is to promote commercial businesses to increase the city's tax base, as well as provide additional and needed services in our community, such as maybe a grocery store, a hardware store, a drugstore, etc. The tax base in Rockville has typically consisted of a high level of residential properties. About 4% of the city's assessed market value is commercial, and that's compared to about 21% for the cities in our area, and that includes Avon, Cold Spring, Richmond, Sartell. So I think there's definitely room to
try to bring
some additional industry into our city. My next priorities are to promote ordinances and smart growth that preserve and protect our lakes, rivers, wetlands, woods, and other natural resources, and to promote residential growth that maintains the rural character of Rockville. Rockville is, I think, unique and
fortunate
to have an abundance of natural resources, including Grand Lake and Pleasant Lake, the Sauk River, as well as several other natural environment lakes and streams. I would like to see Rockville conservation design, which is a new way of thinking and an amazing way to create beautiful developments that guarantee that natural open space and features will be permanently preserved, as well as contributing to the rural character and feel of the city. I think our legacy for Rockville should be a community that works together for controlled growth, open space preservation, and greater community spirit and involvement. And I would appreciate you considering voting for me on November 7th. Thank you.